Hello everyone, welcome back. This is a continuation on the MiG 170. As you know from last time, that the receptacle on this doesn't quite match with this here. As you can see, this is the plug here, and this is the plug on your generator, at least on this particular model here, the 3200 continuous 4000 watt max. And so you got all these outlets here, and you know, you got your 120, 120, 120, 120, and then you have this here, which is 120/240, and that's a little confusing for me at first, but kind of figured it out. But it turns out there's not too many adapters out there that you could just buy off the shelf and just do this with your welder. So what I had to do was, you know, I had to make one. So this is the plug here, and it says here 30 amp, 125, 250 volt, and this is the plug that fits in here, and this is kind of the code for it. It's lock 1430 P. Don't know exactly. I know the L means lock. I don't know what the 14 is, but maybe the type of plug it is, or type of shape. And then the 30 meaning the 30 amps here, and then P as in plug, seems like. So, and then this is a 12 gauge wire. You know, in the manual, I think it recommends if you're going to use an extension, use 10 gauge, but this is just so short. It's only about 3.5 feet. So I had to plug this in, and it's kind of weird how it's set up. There's the ground, so the green wire somewhere around here. Yeah, there it is. You see the green wire, and the green goes to the green screw, which is the ground, and then you get this little pink and white and black. So and on these, on the back here, when you hook them up, there's the ground that you just connect to the ground, which is the green wire. And then there's the X. There's an X, there's a W, and there's a Y, I believe. And so I'm not an electrician, but it just made sense that maybe W means white, X is probably the hot or the black wire, and the Y would be this third wire that we got here. And so I just connected that way, and I guess I probably lucked out. But that was the easy part. The hard part was, okay, I got four wires here, and this is the receptacle to the welder. And there's only three connections, as you can see. The ground, the hot, and another hot or the common. So I didn't know at the time, and what I did was I put the white wire in here and plugged up this wire right here. But basically these are just two hot wires, and this is a common. So this being the main hot wire and the secondary hot wire. And so at the time I didn't know, and I put the white wire in here, plugged it in, and you know, the fan turned on. It turned on, but the fan was going and everything, but it wouldn't do anything beyond that. I could see the fan rolling in here, and it wouldn't go. And so guess what I did. You know, I get this free multimeter here, and basically I turned it up here. I don't know if you can see that here. AC voltage, 750, 200. So I always set it on the higher, so it doesn't, you know, fry up my free multimeter. And then let me see if I can do this in a way that kind of shows you guys a little bit better. There we go. So basically I just, from that point on, the sun's coming out, I touched it here. And with this white wire being in here, I only got a reading of 125 volts. And I was like, well, that's not gonna work. I must be doing something wrong. And so I figured this might be another hot wire. So if I put this hot wire in here where this would be, maybe it would be another 120, and I would get 250 or 240. And so I put this in, capped this off. This is the ground, which is kind of simple, just stays there. And then tested it again on the voltage, and once you know it, of course it's zero now, it's not on, but it came out to 250 volts. So I was like, okay, wow, it worked. And this plug is it's a receptacle. It's a 6-50 amp. There it is, if you can see that. NEMA 6-50. And that's, well, that's just the way it is. That's what works with it. So turns out they don't make adapters readily available for a welding situation. So this is what I had to basically, had to buy the receptacle here, buy that plug there, buy the four wire. This is four wire, two hots, a common and a ground, 12 gauge stranded wire, but it, you know, I think 12 gauge worked. And basically, you know, you just have to make it in order to make it work, because they don't, it's not something that's just done, because I was pulling my hair out trying to find something. So here you go, I plugged it in, locked it up, there we go, locked it, and then this just simply just plugs in. There we go, move that multimeter away. So there it is, it's all plugged in, turned off. And of course, the reason I was doing this was because I was trying to help a neighborhood kid weld his little go-kart, little motor on it, weld his frame back together. Looks like he was jumping some curbs, and so broke several places on the frame. Anyways, I already did that for him, so I just kind of want to do this on the follow-up to kind of show you that this setup can work. If you have one of these generators, I got one just for a backup to a power situation. You know, I was planning on doing, eventually sub-panel to my garage here, but I haven't done that yet because copper is so damn expensive. So this is just another alternative here, where I'm taking my generator and using the 240 volt plug, wiring it, the plug and the receptacle to be 240, of course, because you can also set it up to be 120 as well. And then I'm gonna test out, and I already know it works because I've already done it, so I'm just kinda following up on it for you guys here. I'm kind of sure some of you might have been curious to see if it does work. So, okay. And so I already measured the thickness, made the settings here. So let me just get my welding helmet here. Thank you. Hopefully you saw that. I'll take you out and kind of show you. I noticed right off the bat, compared to the 90 amp, this thing rocks. It with a little bit more the power that it has, it just makes the weld go by so much faster. Because when I had the 90 amp, this is what I did here with the 170. To make the same weld with the 90 amp, it would have taken me longer. I would have had to hold it there and just slowly go. With the 170, if I kept it there any longer, it would literally burn through. And then what I did to kind of show how strong it is burned a hole right through it. So I just went ahead and turned it on to max power 2. Right now it was set on minimum on 2 with a speed of 2. And then what I did is I put it on max 2 and then I increased it to 4. And you could hear the generator going, and there you go, you saw it burn right through. I don't know how bright the camera would have been showing, but it burned right through real quick. Of course it's not that thick. It's I measured several places with the digital caliper, and it ranged from 1.5 millimeters to 1.36, depended where I was and how much debris was here. But the smallest measurement I got was 1.37 millimeters. The biggest was 1.58, and again, this, you know, it's curving a little bit, as you can see from my little test welds here. So but I was just following the guidelines on here. On the flux core side, and then it was in between these two settings. So I put it on to actually 4 in the beginning, and if I moved the welder really fast over, I had to move the welder really fast over it to keep up with the bead, or it would have burned a hole. So I turned it actually down to 2 so I could just go a little bit slower. 3 might have been the right speed, but man, the power on this is awesome. If you have a 90 and it's a little too slow for you, or you had fun practicing with it, and you feel a little need to do a little bit more, 170 going to 170, or if you want, you can jump up to the 180. Wouldn't be a bad option. And unfortunately, I know a lot of you don't have 240 outlets, but if you have a generator, and most of these generators have a 20 amp 240, just do what I did. Get the plug, a cord, and a plug. So like I said, this is a L1430P, so lock 1430 amp plug to a 650 amp receptacle here, and this is the only one I could find here. But the way it's hooked up here is you take your two hot wires, the black and this pinkish reddish one, and this is your common. You can cap that off or plug that off here, and then your ground, and these two are 120 120, giving you 240 or 250, so it says. And if you have a digital multimeter, go ahead and test it. You can just touch it on the back here, and then you'll see that it's giving you 240 or 250. Confirm it. You know, you can touch these two, the ground and one of the hots here, that would be 125. You do the same over here, it'd be 125, and then so that's how you would wire it, and this just be uncapped. You can make it another 120 if you you wanted to, just take out one of the second hot wire and put in your common wire in there, and that'll give you 120, 125 actually. And so there you go. This was really not that expensive. I know it's, you go to the big box stores and you buy these outlets, you know, they probably charge you a lot more than if you went to some specialty electrical supply hardware store. But it was, I would say, about $25 for this setup here. Not too bad, considering, you know, the other option is to go ahead and put a sub panel in and wire out your garage, which I would say about 100 feet of number 8 wire. Man, you're looking at probably like $300. So this is just you know, just temporary until I can wire everything, but I can do it now. So anyways, I hope this was helpful for you guys. If you're, I know these go on sale a lot, and a lot of people probably have these. Every time I go in there, I always see somebody walking out with one of these generators. Really inexpensive. Or if you don't have to have this generator, you could have any generator. But if you have a welder, and you want to be a little bit mobile, or you want to jump up to a 240, yeah, this could be a good way to do it. And it's mobile, so you can do this anywhere. So this could be an option for anybody out there. So anyways, you know, hopefully this helps. If you have any comments, please make a comment. Feel free to subscribe. Also, feel free to make any video responses here. So thank you very much, and stay tuned for the next episode. Bye. The plug here, and this is the plug on your generator, at least on this particular model here. The 3200 continuous 4000 watt max. And so you got all these outlets here, and you know, you got your 120, 120, 120, 120, and then you have this here, which is 120/240, and that's it is our type of shape. And then the 30 meaning the 30 amps here, and then P as in plug, seems like. So, and then this is a 12 gauge wire. You know, in the manual, I think it recommends if you're going to use it. Hello everyone, welcome back. This is a continuation on the MIG 170. As you know from last time, that the receptacle on this doesn't quite match with this here. As you can see, this is and it says here 30 amp, 125, 250 volt, and this is the plug that fits in here, and this is kind of the code for it. It's lock 1430P. Don't know exactly. I know the L means lock. I don't know what the 14 is, but maybe the type of plug. A little confusing for me at first, but kind of figured it out. But it turns out there's not too many adapters out there that you could just buy off the shelf and just do this with your welder. So what I had to do was, you know, I had to make one. So this is the plug here.